गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन वी विल बी स्टडिंग फ्यू ऑफ द टॉपिक्स ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट। द टॉपिक्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस सेशन आर इनकम सेविंग्स एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट, इंडस्ट्री ट्रेड बैलेंस ऑफ पेमेंट्स, मनी फाइनेंस प्राइसेस, अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट पॉवर्टी, रीजनल इम्बैलेंसेस, सोशल इनजस्टिस, इन्फ्लेशन, पैरेलल इकोनॉमी, इंडस्ट्रियल सिकनेस। सो स्टार्टिंग विद दिस सेशन वी विल फोकस ऑन द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, एंड द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज इनकम सेविंग्स एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट। एज वी ऑल नो, इकोनॉमी इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, बिकॉज इन्वेस्टमेंट्स लीड्स टू इनकम जनरेशन, एंड इनकम जनरेशन लीड्स टू consumption and further savings. Therefore, it is very important to understand and acknowledge that in order for an economy to work efficiently and effectively, the rate of investment should always be at the optimum level. When we talk about the meaning of income, therefore the income is the revenue a business earns from selling goods or services, or the money an individual receives in compensation for his or her services. Now, this is the basic definition or meaning of the income. Therefore, we can easily say that income is the returns that an individual or a business gets on their efforts or the offerings that they provide in terms of goods or services. Then comes savings. Savings refers to the excess of disposable income over consumption expenditure. It means that savings is the amount of money that is left after consuming from the income. For example, if a person income is $100 and if he consumes $50 per month, therefore $50 is left as a savings for the month of his income. Next is investment. Investment is basically, in simple words, it is change in capital stock or inventory pertaining to a business venture. It means that investment means creation of something. When a money is used in order to create value addition, for example, raw material is used and further increase the value, and in the process of increasing the value, it is called production. So when a business is trying to increase the value of the product, then it is termed as an investment. Now moving to the next slide, it is industry and trade. Therefore, what is industry? Industry is basically where the investment takes place. It is where there are different sectors. For example, we have information technology, we have FMCG, we have travel and tourism, we have media and mass communication, we have transportation, we have the capital goods manufacturing sector, we have in telecommunication and construction sector, realty sector. There are so many sectors in which the manufacturing of goods and services or the activities pertaining to the sector are limited to that particular industry. For example, in a telecommunication sector, only telecom related activities will take place among the industry or among the companies. Therefore, when we talk about trade, so trade is basically the buying and selling of goods that is taking place in the market among buyers and sellers who are exchanging at a certain price of the product or services. Therefore, when we talk about trade is basically the rate at which buyers and sellers are able to transact in a market. Now moving towards balance of payment. Now balance of payment is a concept that focuses on statement of all transactions made between entities in one country and rest of the world over a defined period of time. Here we have to focus one thing. that when we are saying balance of payment, then balance of payment is a concept that records all the financial transactions of the citizens in a particular country and the citizens making the transactions in other parts of the world. It means that all the financial transactions that are taking place from the people who are coming to our country and our people going to the outside country. Therefore, it will tell us whether we are having positive balance of payment or negative balance of payment. Balance of payment usually records the transactions related with trade activities like import and export of the goods and services between our country and the rest of the world. It also records the financial investments like foreign direct investment, foreign institutional investment, and the portfolio investments like the stock market investments. It also records the foreign exchange reserves of the country in a particular period of time. Now moving towards money, finance and prices. Now first of all, we have to consider that money is a unit of exchange in a particular country. The currency can be in any form, but the basic meaning is it is a medium to basically value the trade or basically try to do the trade among buyer and seller. Therefore, money is an object that is accepted as a payment method for goods and services or payment of debt in a particular country. Now, coming to finance, in terms of finance, it is basically very broad term which is divided into three categories: public finance, corporate finance, personal finance. Finance is a term that is basically used in order to define the management of money. Like if we talk about personal finance, then how an individual is managing his income in terms of his savings, consumption and investment priorities. That is called basically finance. Now coming to the price. The price is basically the amount or the expenditure in terms of making a particular good, and then profit is added in order to make the product. Product, its price is being discovered by charging a particular amount of profit over the cost. Now when any business manufactures certain product, then a cost is incurred, and that cost is basically what we call, it is the expenses or the investment made by the business. Therefore, when we talk about the prices is cost plus profit of a business over their goods and services offerings. So now moving towards the next slide, unemployment, poverty. Unemployment is basically a condition in the economy whereby a person who is actively searching for employment is unable to find work. That means if an individual is looking for employment opportunities but is unable to get the employment, that is a situation of unemployment. It also signifies the condition or health of the economy. Now coming to poverty. Poverty is a state or a condition in which a person or a community lacks the financial resources. That means they don't have enough money or income to have minimum standard of living, or they are not able to meet their ends in order to survive, and therefore they are termed under poverty line. Now coming to regional imbalances. Regional imbalances are basically disparities or wide gaps or differences in per capita income, literacy rate, health, education. There can be any sector or any field in which there is gap. That gap basically creates imbalances. Now coming to social injustice. Social injustice is basically a situation in which equals are treated unequal and unequal are treated equal. it is a situation of discrimination based on ageism. That means when you are having certain discrimination based on certain factors, like aged people are not given importance, or age is considered as a factor of discrimination, or like caste is considered a factor of discrimination, or any kind of factor that can create discrimination among the people, then that is regarded as social injustice. So now, inflation and parallel economy. Inflation is basically a term that is used to define the rise in the prices of goods and services in the economy due to the several reasons. There can be increase in the demand that is creating the pressure on prices, and there can be economic factors also. Now, parallel economy is basically a condition in which the illegal activities, parallel economy is the functioning of an unsanctioned sector in the economy whose objectives run in opposite to the objective of official sanctioned or legitimate sector. Therefore, it is parallel economy is basically unaccounted activities, illegal activities that are done in order to avoid taxes. These are basically illegal and unsanctioned activities that run side by side the normal economic activities. Industrial sickness. Now, industrial sickness is basically a word that is used to define basically the losses to the industry in which due to any government policy or any kind of industrial policy, the companies or businesses are not making profits, or they are losing their businesses, they are not making enough in order to sustain their businesses, that is leading to the losses, and that losses are creating bankruptcies, and that is leading to the industrial sickness. Therefore, I think when we see all these topics, these are very important from an economic perspective and define the health of the economy. Now, I thank you all for this presentation. Have a nice day, and God bless you all.